So it's time to sit or lie back. Listen, preferably using headphones. Sometimes you hear my voice coming to you from the left. And sometimes you hear my voice coming to you from the right. And sometimes you'll hear my voice in many different ways. And whichever way you hear my voice will go with you. And it will be just the right way for your unconscious to begin to learn, to appreciate, to say thank you, and to count your blessings for the many miracles in life, to be grateful for that life is good and life is wonderful. So take a moment now just to listen to the sound of the music. And take a deep, deep, deep breath in. And when you breathe out, just let your mind settle. Let any thoughts just drift off. And focus upon your breathing comfortably. Smoothly in and gently out. That's right. The mind will tend to wander. So just simply bring your attention back to your breathing now. Smoothly and gently in and comfortably relax as you breathe out. That's right. And focus again on your breathing once more, so that your focus of attention is on comfort and ease. Breathing smoothly and gently in. And relax deeper down inside as you breathe out now.
Deeper and deeper still.
And inside your mind, just say the word soften. And soften all the muscles from the top of your head down to the tips of your toes,
all the way down.
And as you focus on your breathing comfortably,
with comfort and ease, deeper still,
notice how present you can be. That's right.
All the way down.
And with comfort and ease, focus your attention now to the center of your body, just below the navel. There's a point deep inside of you. The center of gravity.
Place where you feel balanced.
And imagine a bright red light.
A delightful light.
And just imagine the red light starts to shine down, down through your legs,
all the way down.
Down into the earth beneath you.
light descends down into the soil. It's like roots extending,
like the roots of trees,
down through the earth's crust,
feeling centered and grounded,
through the mantle, down to the very center of the earth,
the core.
And imagine that the center of the earth is a jewel,
a bright jewel,
a precious jewel. And the red light shines and lights up that jewel, and the red light gets brighter.
You feel it with delight.
And the bright light begins to come back up through the earth, from the center, through the mantle,
to your center,
through the crust, back up to you, to that center point of gravity.
You place a balance.
The red light shines up through you,
flows through you,
up your spine, through the crown of your head, off into the universe. So that at all times in life you can be centered and grounded, connected to the earth
and the universe beyond. You are the center of the universe.
And shining down from above, imagine a bright white light. A white light that shines down upon your crown and flows down through your body, down past that centered point, down, deep down to the center of the earth,
to the very core,
connecting you to the universe above. And people say that you are the center of the universe, so imagine the white light extending from that center point out in all directions,
shining bright like a star,
connecting you to every part of the earth
and beyond,
extending out to the planets, to the stars beyond. Connecting you to all that is, all that was, all that will ever be.
That's right.
And inside your mind, begin to get that feeling of sincere thank you.
Thank you.
That moment when someone gave you a present and you were pleasantly surprised.
And surprised so pleasantly.
And you said thank you.
With sincere thanks and gratitude.
And have that sincere thank you spread from you. Have it flow out in all directions, above and below, in front of you, behind, to the sides, and all of the gaps in between. Let the thank yous extend beyond you,
out into the universe, and give thanks to all the words of wisdom.
We begin by saying thank you to you,
to all of the people who've cultivated.
Say thank you to who you are,
the magnificent you,
to the way you see yourself,
the unique you,
to your identity. Say thank you to all of the positive beliefs you have about who you are, and begin to believe in the wisdom. Say thank you to all the things you value that are important to you. Say thank you to all of your skills and all of your talents.
You simply will not be the same person you just do now, after consciously giving thanks each day for the abundance.
Say thank you to all of the capabilities and behaviors that you have.
Set in motion an ancient spiritual law.
Things that maybe you just take for granted.
All you have and are grateful for.
Say yes to who you are. Appreciate who you are. Be grateful for who you are.
May love and laughter light your days and warm your heart and home. May good and faithful friends be yours.
Say thank you.
May peace
have gratitude and appreciation for all of the miracles that are you.
Bring the best to you and yours.
Say thank you to yourselves. Different parts of the cells
that gave someone a gift,
just do what they do,
thank you for it.
Unconscious.
Would you be likely to give them another? And life is the same way.
Mitochondria.
In order to attract
energy.
More of the blessings that life has to offer, you must truly appreciate
the DNA,
what you have.
The proteins, the amino acids.
Gratitude can transform common days into Thanksgiving days.
Say thank you to the
turn
red blood cells, the white
joy.
Blood cells.
Change ordinary opportunities into blessings.
Say thank you to the cells of the skin, of the hair.
There is a law of gratitude, and it is the natural principle.
Say thank you
and
appreciate the cells of your eyes. Say thank you to your ears that hear the world.
It cannot fail to reach that to which it is addressed. And the reaction.
Say thank you to your nose that enables you to experience the sense of world around you. And say thank you to your mouth, your teeth.
When something less than pleasant occurs.
To your tongue and your voice. Say thank you to your arms and hands and fingers.
Let us be grateful to people who make us happy. They are the charming gardeners who make
us. Say thank you to your heart that beats.
Marcel Proust.
Millions of times in a lifetime.
As we express our gratitude,
and to your lungs that breathe in the air.
Highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. John F. Kennedy.
To the liver and to the kidneys.
At times, our own life goes out.
Thank you to your stomach that digests the food,
and
gives you all the energy you need.
Each of us is caused to think with deep gratitude of those who have lighted the flame within us.
Say thank you to your legs, your
develop
feet,
an attitude
and
of
toes.
Gratitude and give thanks for everything that happens to you. Knowing that
to your soul
is a step
and heal
achieving something
now.
Bigger and better than your current situation. Brian Tracy.
Everyday miracles of life.
Feeling gratitude and not expressing it.
Appreciate
it. Like
and say thank you to you.
Gratitude bestows reverence.
And begin to extend your sincere thanks and gratitude beyond you.
Those transcendent moments of awe that change forever how we experience life and the world.
To your closest friends.
John Milton. Gratitude helps you to grow and expand. Gratitude
to your family.
Gratitude is not only the greatest of virtues.
Take a moment and bring to mind all the people you love
Marcus
and that love you.
Gratitude is the sign of noble souls. Esau.
And say thank you for them being in your life.
Gratitude is the inward feeling of kindness received. Thankfulness is the natural impulse to express that feeling. Thanksgiving
is the following of that impulse.
And say thank you to the people from the past. People that maybe you loved.
Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates a vision for
maybe
tomorrow.
People you didn't get on with.
Gratitude to gratitude always gives birth.
But take a moment to be grateful for the lessons that you learned from them.
I would maintain that thanks are the highest form of thought, and that gratitude is
inside your mind. Forgive them.
G.K. Chesterton.
Thank them for giving you the lessons.
Joy is the simplest form of gratitude. The essence of all beautiful art, all great art, is gratitude.
And say thank you for all the people that you never get to meet that are part of your life.
Or take them with gratitude.
The eye, the people that make your food, that plant the seeds that grow.
Each new morning with
the
his
people
light, for rest and shelter
who deliver all of the things we take for granted now.
Friends, for everything my goodness sends. Ralph Waldo Emerson.
Say thank you for everyone
if you count all your assets,
who's involved in anything you've ever purchased or bought.
He is a wise man.
Anything you've ever used.
For the things which he has not, but rejoices for those which he has. Gratitude is the best attitude.
And appreciate how connected we all are.
We can be said to be alive in those moments when our hearts are conscious of our treasures. There are two kinds of gratitude.
And say thank you to all of the things in your life. The stuff of life.
The larger kind we feel for what we give.
The computers.
Gratitude is an opener of
the mobile devices that people use now.
Marianne Williams.
For transport,
the music of the heart, when its chords are swept by the breeze of kindness.
All of the everyday miracles,
trivial character, but the ones which strike deep.
But hundreds of years ago,
appreciating heart,
it would have seemed like magic.
Granted, the very things that most deserve our gratitude. All that we behold.
Take a moment and imagine your home. Appreciate
that. The more things you will have to express gratitude for. I awoke this morning with devout thanksgiving for my friends, the old and the new. Join me in the pure atmosphere of gratitude for life. One regret, dear world, that I'm determined not to have when I'm
you can begin to see the world in a new way. In a grateful way.
To enact gratitude is generous.
In a way where you can start to count your blessings.
Gratitude is to touch heaven. Happiness cannot be traveled.
That's right.
Owned, earned, worn, or consumed. Happiness is the spiritual experience.
The world has enough beautiful mountains and meadows, spectacular skies and serene lakes. It has enough lush forests, flowered fields and sandy
beaches.
It has plenty of stars and the promise of a new sunrise and sunset every day.
To educate yourself for the
but the world needs more of its people to appreciate and enjoy it.
But
what you focus on expands,
kind of
and when you focus on the goodness in your life, you create more of
nothing
it.
That is done for you is
opportunities, relationships.
Everything
even money flowed my way when I learned to be grateful no matter what happened in my life.
Never to put off the word or action for the expression of gratitude.
Be grateful and look to this day, for it is life.
Let us rise up and be thankful. For if we didn't learn a lot today, at least we learned a little.
The very life of your one true, wonderful life.
At least we didn't get sick.
In its brief course lies all the truth of existence, the joy of growth, the splendor of peace, the bliss of being love, the glory of living. Your yesterday is but a fading memory of what was, and tomorrow a wistful dream of possibilities. So devote to being grateful for each day well lived. It makes every yesterday a fond, happy memory, a better past. And every tomorrow a desire and a vision of anticipated hope, a brighter future. Therefore look to this day, the eternal now, your one true present. Enjoy the gift. Look to your day and be grateful. Now in a moment I'm going to count from 1 to 10. And when I count from 1 to 10, when I get to 10, you can then open your eyes, feel refreshed, alert. And if you're listening to this before you go to sleep, when I get to 10, you can just sleep deeply and awaken at the time that's just right and appropriate for you. One, two, three. Aware of the sound of the music. Four, five, six. Aware of the sound of my voice. We'll go with you. Seven, eight. Bring your attention back to the room, feeling refreshed, alert, clear-headed. 9, 10, take a deep, deep breath in, and then open your eyes.